It's another edition of Fight News Now. Welcome to the show. Today we're taking a final look at UFC 202 as we head into Saturday night as we chat with John Ramdina and Robin Black about some of the key fights, including the rematch involving Nate Diaz and Conor McGregor, plus the latest episodes of UFC Embedded and much more as we head into Las Vegas. I'm here with Robin Black and John Ramdian. This is the final time we're going to sit down and talk about UFC 202.
Thank God.
You hit fatigue on this card?
I have, because we want to get to the fight. We want it to be Saturday night around midnight, because we've been...
You don't want to hear about a water bottle ever again.
I don't. I just want to see the beauty of what we're going to see inside of that cage, because we know what Conor McGregor's capable of. We know what Nathan Diaz is capable of. What I like is the idea that each one of these... adversaries have elevated the game for their opponent on Saturday night. I think we're going to see the best version of Conor McGregor, and I think we're going to see the best version of Nathan Diaz, and the fans are going to be the ones that get the benefit.
Nathan Diaz, and he calls him Nathan Diaz, by the way, because that's what Nick and every single member of their entourage call them. Just watch on television. People are like, why does that guy keep calling him Nathan Diaz? That's his name, and that's what everyone who knows him calls him. But he's been working very hard to get Conor McGregor off of his game. The McGregor game plan over the last 10 weeks or more has been to fight free of emotion, to just be disconnected from the emotion in the fight. And man, that's not a good scene if you're Conor McGregor or his people. Seeing him kind of lose control, pick up entire cans of things and lob them into a crowd, that's not planned. That is losing track of your emotion. Now, at the time that we're recording this, we have not yet seen the weigh-ins. That's the magic of television. If what you see on the weigh-ins is a Conor McGregor whose heart rate doesn't get up, watch his breathing. Is he wound up? Is he stressed out? Or is he disconnected? Because that press conference and all of that stress would have been a last-minute reminder of those guys what the mission is. And the mission is do not be emotional. If he's emotional at those weigh-ins, and it's real, watch his breathing to see if it's real, then this is a bad sign. But if he's calm and he's relaxed and he's disconnected from it, he's going to be in good shape to go in and do his thing.
Do you guys think that that's intentional on Diaz's part to really throw this guy, or is that merely a byproduct of Conor McGregor realizing how important this fight is, and this is just Nate Diaz acting as though he would with any opponent?
Well, I think Nathan Diaz, he's talked about it throughout his entire career. He said, I got into the game because of my older brother, Nick, was in mixed martial arts. I tagged along. I ended up studying jiu-jitsu and studying boxing and became a mixed martial arts professional. And what better example can you have in how to make an impact in the sport than having your older brother, Nick Diaz, who's looking out for you? And we've seen Nick do it time and time again. We've heard his adversaries, whether it be George St. Pierre or Carlos Condit, say you're prepared, but then the guy starts talking to you and he starts bitch slapping you and he's doing all these things to throw you off your game, and you try to mentally stay prepared, but in the fire, it's just something completely different. Nathan Diaz took a page out of his brother's book. It's been working. For the most part, he throws fighters off when he points at them and he says, I just bitch slapped you. And then they get more intense and they come after him. And I would imagine that is part of the strategy. We'll probably see that in this main event of UFC 202.
You talk to my man Carlos Condit, and he executed the perfect game plan against the big Diaz, against Nick Diaz. And he knew going in, he had been prepared for the fact that the game plan that he had would frustrate Nick Diaz. He knew that Nick Diaz would come back at him. He'd be saying things about his mother. When Conor freaked out, a lot of his friends and fans and people, it's like, well, somebody hit his girl. Well, that doesn't mean you lose control. I understand we would all, if somebody touches my wife, man. But your mission is to master yourself. Don't expect that Nate Diaz will not say unbelievable things about your mother in the heat of battle. He will not say things you can't even imagine that he will claim he has done with your woman. He will say whatever is necessary. And no matter what it is, you have to master yourself.
The art of war.
That's the art of war, and that's what Carlos did. Carlos also knew that not only was this guy going to do it, 16,000 people were going to try to convince him not to fight the way that he would win that fight. And he went in prepared. Didn't matter what he said about his mother. Didn't matter what he said about his girl. Didn't matter what those 16,000 people said. He mastered that fight and he beat Nick Diaz. That's how you do it. Conor showed a little crack in that at that press conference.
Is everybody capable of that? Is everybody that is a professional.
Well, that's the question. Yeah. Do you guys believe that Conor McGregor can divorce himself from the emotion? It's all well and good that you're preparing to go in and you have a game plan, you're going to conserve energy, but when you're in the heat of that, in the middle of that arena, and Nate Diaz is just verbally attacking you, are you going to start fighting with emotion? I think that's really important here. A lot of times we just look at Nate Diaz's antics as just comical. There is a strategy behind all of this. And if Conor McGregor starts fighting emotionally early in that fight, that plays right into the hands of Nate Diaz.
And it also depends on if Conor McGregor's in a hole, if he has to dig himself out because Nathan Diaz was able to dictate the pace, put Conor into bad spots, and then on top of that, verbally assault him. And then his energy starts going down because he just wants it more. I have to teach this guy a lesson, playing right into the hands of Nathan Diaz. Or is he just emotionless? Does he go and just really, it's just white noise. It doesn't matter. Whatever Nathan Diaz says, it's really irrelevant. You go out and the mission is break his body.
And one of the things that a lot of these fighters are seeking, again, Carlos Condit is a beautiful example of it. They're seeking mastery of self. To go into a fight is about mastering yourself, mastering your own physicality, mastering fear, mastering emotion, all of that. So that is a part of the journey of seeking to be a great fighter. And you know, to do it, sometimes you just have to let the wheel go. If you, what do they say when you're gonna crash your car? Sometimes you turn into the skid. If you're just cranking the wheel, you lose control of that thing. Trying too hard to control every situation. If you're a control freak, you can't do that. And that, this fight is incredible for a million reasons. But that is going to be one of the things to watch for, is can Conor McGregor master himself? Or has Nate Diaz mastered him? And that's gonna be fascinating.
I think also another question is, what do you want? What do these fighters want out of this? I think when you're talking about Carlos Condit, you talk to some of the best fighters, best trainers on the planet, and we say, assess Carlos Condit. They'll be like, well, this guy's an incredible martial artist, fighter. He's revered. We all know that. We know he's a former champion. He'll get to walk away from the sport with a ton of respect. Conor McGregor, yes, he's a champion, but he's also a spectacle, and that's what people want to tune into. The majority of fans want to tune in to see the spectacle, even if he is a brilliant martial artist. They want to see what he's going to say, and because of that, a guy like Conor McGregor gets to leave the sport with way more money and way more opportunities than a guy like Carlos Condit.
You know, and it was really interesting when Conor fought Aldo, they had all of these fighters there for us to talk to, and Carlos Condit was one of the guys I wanted to talk to the most. And I went around a second time and a third time to try to absorb information. And each of the three times that I was there, somebody still asked him about that Nick Diaz fight and how he feels about it. And he said, well, you know, I know that in his entire library of brilliance in the cage, there are still some people who only know that fight and think he's a certain thing. But he doesn't care because he was there to master the situation. He was there to win that fight, to be the better martial artist and come out the victor. And there was a lot on the line. You come out and you fight George St. Pierre for an interim belt. Yep. He has a UFC belt because of that performance. He fought George St. Pierre. That fight probably made him more money than he'd ever made in his life. All of that was mastering yourself and ignoring the 16,000 boos and dealing with the reality that many less educated people than Carlos Condit will go through life going, that guy's a pussy. Nick didn't show up and fight Nick. Yeah. If he fought real, Nick would have beat him. Irrelevant to Carlos Condit. It has to be irrelevant in the fight. And I don't know that McGregor is built that way. McGregor wants to entertain. He wants to please. He wants to ignite the audience. Yeah. He wants to lead. This one's not about that.
Two quick things before we wrap up. Nick Diaz won't be cornering Nate. He hasn't cornered him for his last two fights, and Nate's looked tremendous in the Michael Johnson and first McGregor fights. Do you look at that as a factor? This appeared, you know, Nate, I think, was of the belief Nick would be there. Do you think it is a factor?
I don't, because there was an interview with Nick Diaz, and he said, you know, whenever one of the members of my team, when they have a big fight, I make sure that I'm there for them because they were there for me when I had some of my biggest fights. And you know 100% that Nick would have been there the entire time during this Nathan Diaz camp. So he certainly spent the time ensuring that his little brother will be prepared for what is undoubtedly the biggest fight of his mixed martial arts career.
100%. You know, of course, people are asking everybody, who's going to win this fight? who do you think is going to win this fight? And we'll often tell you there's so many variables. Go ahead and guess. She'll be right 52% of the time. This one is about that. Do I believe Conor McGregor can beat this Nate Diaz? 100% I do. But it's really up to whether or not he can master himself in the situation. Because if he does not, Nate Diaz will push him until he pushes back, and Nate Diaz will take over. You have to watch the demeanor of Conor McGregor. If he is free in this fight, then he has a good likelihood to win it. If he is not, if he's gripping it tight and he's biting down on that mouthpiece and you see the pressure and the stress in his breathing, that is not an excuse. That's something Nate Diaz did to him. This fight's gonna be fascinating. I can't wait to see it. I'm a big fan of both guys. I'm cheering for both guys. In the end, I'm a Conor McGregor mark, but I cannot wait to see how this goes down.
We are all out of time. We are gonna be back on Saturday night. Tune into our UFC 202 preview show at 7 p.m. Eastern time, counting down to the rematch between Nate Diaz and Conor McGregor.